This programming is brought to you by Infurrow Leader FMC. Visit your FMC retailer or infurrow.ag.fmc.com to learn more.
We continue our focus on next season and the drive to win the furrow today, building the perfect seedbed from the ground up. Fall field work is wrapping up for Nebraska farmer Dan Aspergren.
We try to get all of our field work done in the fall.
As a strip-till operation, that means taking a hybrid approach, only tilling in what will become next year's furrow and leaving between the rows untouched. Aspergren says they're using shanks rather than coulters.
We use shanks to break compaction, create a seed bed to plant on next spring, and apply the fertilizer. Our dry, like I said earlier, approximately 6 inches deep where the root zone root mass is going to be.
I think about that shank, and I want that shank half an inch below the compaction layer that's in that field.
Mick Godekin is a tillage system agronomist. He says managing compaction is vital to good root growth each spring.
Natural compaction occurs below 12 inches deep, and we're never going to do anything about that. What we can manage is that in that top 12 inches.
He says a typical disc type of tillage will create a compaction layer between 3 and 8 inches deep.
I want to set that shank just half an inch below that compaction layer, create a lifting effect, shattering that compaction and creating a nice trench for that seed to promote root growth and flourish and grow within that and capture those nutrients within that strip.
Given the current high cost of nutrients, efficiency is going to be the key to profits in 2022.
It's probably one of the more efficient ways to apply fertilizer because it's where it needs it. It's where the root zone is.
Keeping waste to a minimum and setting up to maximize returns next season.